Hi, stranger.
Hi.
First question. When you think money, what's the first emotion that comes to your mind?
Comfort.
Comfort? Why comfort?
Because there's security with money.
Ah.
I have a trust fund.
Yay, trust fund! Fantastic. Okay.
But I didn't have a trust fund until I was 66 years old, which I am now.
Oh, wow.
I worked like my whole life. And I created my own, like livelihood in New York City. I created my life as a chef, my life as a photo stylist, and, you know, I made it in New York, what can I say? Not easy.
You make it here in New York, you make it anywhere.
Yeah, but I think it was probably easier to do at my age. I think it's harder for millennials. I think that millennials are facing a very difficult time.
Mm.
But so, yeah, money, like, I just see, but the reason I have comfort with money is because I acknowledge the fact that I had to save it my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I did. I'm, like, super frugal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I know how to save money, but I also know how to splurge and take, like, long trips to exotic places and not spend much. Airbnb. But before Airbnb, I always found, like, you know, the cool hotel on the beach in Thailand. I just didn't go to the Four Seasons.
Right.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Did you know you would be getting a trust fund in your earlier days?
No.
Ah.
No.
So did money, if you think back, still invoke comfort?
Well, I mean, I felt comfortable when I had it. That's why I worked really hard.
Mm.
You know, I felt more comfortable knowing that I always had everything covered.
Mm.
But I worked hard to do it.
Right.
And it's only through planning. It's like the only thing that would separate me from being a homeless person, besides infinite disasters and bankruptcies that can happen from medical problems and mental illness, it's just planning.
Mm.
The whole thing is about planning, really. It's accept the fact that you don't really need the mani-pedi, but, like, because when you're 60, you're going to wish you had that money to retire on.
Right.
All the mani-pedis you do in your 30s, do your own mani-pedi.
Yeah.
It's not friggin' worth it. And, like, New York women waste more money on grooming than any place I've ever been. Like the $40 blow dries.
Right.
Go dry your own hair. I mean, unless you're really wealthy.
Yeah.
But they're not wealthy, and they just don't know how to, I don't, whatever.
Social pressure?
I can't lecture anybody. Pardon?
Mm. Social pressure?
Social pressure, yes, I guess, because New York is a really, it's probably worse in L.A. to be visually fabulous.
Mm.
But, like, I sort of don't, being a senior citizen, I couldn't care less about that at all.
Well, you look fabulous.
And my advice to people is, which millennials, I think, realize, that material things are not as important as experiences. Mm. That is a great thing to learn early in life. Because the truth is, you know, like, stuff just shows up anyway, and, you know, I've been collecting, like, museum-quality textiles and ethnographic jewelry forever, and then, like, by the time I was 60, I thought, I don't want all this stuff anymore. I mean, it's beautiful, and I enjoy it, but you just have to figure out who to give it to by the time you're 60, because no one's going to live that long. All these people, no, really, like, you know, pretty soon, it's going to be, you know, and like we've been presented with this, like, billionaire president who's miserable, and, like, does he have fun? He doesn't travel. He doesn't even read. So you know what I mean? Like, what kind of a life?
Mm.
If I had that much money, I'd be at the Broadway shows every single night or something.
Yeah.
Or I wouldn't be eating, like, you know, Popeye's chicken on the frigging, you know, Air Force One. I would eat really great food and drink the best wine. But, you know.
Has anything changed once you received the fund? Trust me.
Yeah, I didn't have to worry about anything.
Ah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But except that I have to manage it. I mean, it's not enough, because if you don't manage your money, it's going.
Very true.
I mean, like, all these people win the lotto and then they're broke in, like, 2 years. It's like, there was only X amount, but since I am geared toward understanding the value, like, if I see a penny on the ground, I'll pick it up, because a penny is a fraction of a dollar, is a fraction of a, do you know what I'm saying?
Totally.
It's not a useless commodity. Everything adds up. You know what I'm saying? And